Welcome to Mastering Solutions. In this problem, we'll be using conservation of momentum to find the final speed of the champagne bottle as the cork pops, which is the recoil. So let's write our units down that we're given. They tell us that the mass of the bottle is equal to 1.8 kilograms. The mass of the cork is equal to 7.5 grams, which of course is not in SI units. There's 1,000 grams in a kilogram, so we'll divide this by 1,000, and we will move the decimal place over 3, which will give us 0.0075 kilograms. That can also be written in the scientific notation as 7.5 times 10 to the negative 3 kilograms. And they tell us the final velocity of the cork after it is popped is 20 meters per second. So what we're looking for is the final velocity of the bottle as it recoils. And as we've discussed before, we'll be using conservation of momentum. And the momentum of the system we're defining as the momentum of the bottle plus the momentum of the cork is equal to zero. They both are acting on each other, but there's no outside forces acting on our system that we have defined as these two. So we know that conservation will be conserved. Move the momentum of the cork over to the other side of the equation. So the momentum of the bottle is equal to the negative momentum of the cork. If we break that up, the mass and velocity of the bottle is equal to the negative mass times velocity of the cork. We're trying to find the velocity of the bottle, so let's divide both sides by the mass of the bottle to isolate the velocity, mass of the bottle, and that gives us the velocity of the bottle is equal to the negative mass times the velocity of the cork divided by the mass of the bottle, which could also be expressed this way. The mass of the cork divided by the mass of the bottle multiplied by the velocity of the cork. And the negative can be placed here. It can be placed on the bottle. It can really be placed anywhere. For this picture, if we were to draw it out, we have the champagne bottle here. The cork pops off and it's going this direction. The champagne bottle is going that way. So we can put the negative sign on the velocity of the bottle, which will change all the signs of these. So the picture is showing us that we know that our final answer should give us a negative velocity for the bottle and the positive velocity for the cork. So we're going to leave this one positive and we'll just put the negative here. But either way that we've expressed it here is correct. So when we plug into our equation, we have the final velocity of the bottle will be equal to negative 7.5 times 10 to the negative 3 kilograms. And we're going to divide that by the mass of the bottle, which we said was 1.8 kilograms. And now we'll multiply both of those by 20 meters per second, which was the final velocity of the cork. We have a negative 7.5 times 10 to the negative 3 divided by 1.8 kilogram multiplied by 20 meters per second gives us the final velocity negative 0.083 or negative 8.3 times 10 to the negative 2 meters per second. And that is the final velocity of the champagne bottle after the recoil. Now, for the last part of the question, they ask, would you feel that recoil? I feel like that's kind of subjective. Some people might say, oh, absolutely, I can feel it when it pops. Other people might say, no, not at all. The book, they say that you're likely not going to feel that, but that if you're holding the bottle as it pops, you might notice it a little bit. So if they ask you on the question, would you feel it? Likely no, but again, I feel like it's a little subjective.